Good morning, and welcome to everyone who has gathered here at St. Patrick's Cathedral for this Eucharist on the Epiphany of the Lord. As we observe the wise men opening their treasures in today's gospel and offering gifts to Jesus, we can ask ourselves, what precious gifts can we offer to Jesus today? We can give these gifts to Jesus by giving them to those in need. We acknowledge the First Nations people of the area, and we commit to working and walking together to build a better future for all. Please stand and join in singing the entrance song.
Of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. The 12 days of Christmas have run their course. Whatever gifts your true love sent to you should still keep coming, even though the 12 days are gone. But this day, Epiphany, is the last formal day of our Christmas celebrations. Hence, we're still singing our Christmas carols. This is a moment of acknowledging the revelation, epiphany, and recognition of God. As we begin to celebrate these sacred mysteries, then, let's acknowledge God's call to conversion and reconciliation. Behold, you are Lord, mighty one. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You gather your children from the rising of the sun to its setting. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Yours are kingship, power, and dominion. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who on this day revealed your only begotten Son to the nations by the guidance of a star, grant in your mercy that we, who know you already by faith, may be brought to behold the beauty of your sublime glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the peoples. But the Lord will rise upon you, and his glory will appear over you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Lift up your eyes and look around. They all gather together. They come to you. Your sons shall come from far away, and your daughters shall be carried on their nurses' arms. Then you shall see and be radiant. Your heart shall thrill and rejoice, because the abundance of the sea shall be brought to you. The wealth of the nations shall come to you. A multitude of camels shall cover you, the young camels of Midian and Ephah, and those from Sheba shall come. They shall bring gold and frankincense, and shall proclaim the praise of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Judgment to the king.
King Son, your justice, that he might judge your people in justice, and your poor in right judgment. Lord, every nation will adore you. In his days, justice shall flourish, and peace till the moon fails. He shall rule from sea to sea, from the great river to earth's bounds. Lord, every nation will adore you. The kings shall pay him tribute. From Seba and Sheba, they will bring him gifts. Before him all kings shall fall prostrate. All nations shall come to serve him. Lord, every nation will adore you. For he shall save the poor when they cry, and the needy who are helpless. He will have pity on the weak and save the lives of the poor. Lord, every nation will adore you.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. Surely you have already heard of the commission of God's grace that was given me for you, and how the mystery was made known to me by revelation. In former generations, this mystery was not made known to humanity, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit. That is, the Gentiles have become fellow heirs, members of the same body, and sharers in the promise in Jesus Christ through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of King Herod, behold, Magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising and have come to do him homage." When Herod heard this,
he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it has been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is a shepherd for my people Israel.'" Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word, that I too may go and do him homage." After their audience with the king, they set out, and behold, the star that they had seen at its rising preceded them, until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. Then they opened their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way. The Gospel of the Lord. Secrets and also novel discoveries can be hard to keep to ourselves. We all know the feeling of being the last person in a group to find out some news. But we also all have that one friend who can't keep a secret for the life of them. In truth, I think this urgency to know and also share information is behind the habits of gossip that so often plague our lives. Certainly, the news cycle plays into this desire for knowledge. I remember the day that a good friend of mine told me she and her husband were expecting their first baby. We'd caught up for a coffee. She'd gone through all the pleasantries of how's life, how's work, all these things. And eventually, she brought up her own good news. I can but imagine how much she was mentally biting at the bit for the whole of the preceding conversation, waiting to come to the good news. This good news now toddles around in the shape of my 2-year-old goddaughter. On the Feast of the Epiphany, we celebrate this side of the good news. The Magi show us what it means to seek this insight or revelation, then be changed or challenged by it, and go back different. Each one of us have a kind of knowledge of Christ deep within. Each and every one of us has discovered or perhaps rediscovered a number of times the good news. This might look like anything from a puzzling sense of obligation to attend Mass every Sunday to a deep sense of fascination in all things faith and religion. So, whether religion is part of our day-to-day job, or simply a weekly or even bi-yearly habit, you know something of the good news. And this is significant, given the Old Covenant only allowed for certain people to receive the promise of the good news. Only some people were included in the promise of God's previous covenants. Then also one of the first and longest lasting heresies in our church is that only some of us have this secret knowledge of the good news. But the new covenant and the real truth of the matter both insist that the good news is proclaimed for all. Do you remember the first time you had a sense of this good news? Perhaps it was a faith you learned at home or at school. Perhaps it was a moment of kindness or love from another. Maybe it was some mystical experience of the presence of God. Maybe it was a moment of mercy or acceptance. Maybe it was in beholding something divinely beautiful. Or maybe you've experienced a few of these. Taylor Swift even sings about this experience, saying, "You dream of some epiphany, just one glimpse of relief to make some sense of what you've seen." This feast of the Epiphany of our Lord reminds us of the discovery of the good news. The Magi were so moved by the potential that they travelled from distant lands through all the troubles and dangers that such a journey at that time afforded to seek out the good news. It was only the glimmer of light which drew their attention. And it's often only the glimmer of hope which captures ours. So what are we going to do about it? If we've discovered this good news and it's not supposed to be kept a secret, do we go back to our daily lives like nothing has happened? Or do we even suppress the good news and turn the attention back to ourselves like King Herod? Or perhaps, do we go back in a different way, like the Magi? This good news is something which you know. Perhaps it's the glimmer of hope or an experience of God calling you into a greater life. But you would not be here if you did not know something of the good news. This discovery, this epiphany, calls you to know, love, and serve God. Let's not keep this secret. So what difference does this epiphany bring to your life? How are you going into this year by a different route? Like the Magi, like the shepherds, like Mary, like the first disciples, and like every other saint, like yourself.
Let's stand and profess our symbol of faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. With this glimmer of hope in our hearts, trusting in the Epiphany of God, let's present our prayers to the Heavenly Father.
We pray for Pope Francis and all the bishops that they may be guided by the wisdom of the Magi to lead others to Christ in a truly synodal way. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the leaders of our church that they will be moved by wisdom to work for a negotiated peace in all areas of conflict throughout the world. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the Christian churches in the Middle East. May the wounds of the past be healed by the celebration of Christ's birth, and may peace reign in the land once more. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those in our country who have been affected by recent natural disasters. May the help they need from all governments and agencies be administered quickly to alleviate their troubles so that life may return to some normality. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those in our Toowoomba community who are homeless, in trouble with the law, and those affected by the economic conditions of today's society. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who have died recently. Father Don Murray, Rita Collins, Father Jamie's mother, Joan Robinson, Norma Fitzgerald, Lola Collins, Paul Mahon, and for all those whose anniversary of death occurs around this time. May they take their place among the saints in the heavenly Jerusalem. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer. Father in heaven, receive these prayers like the gifts of the Magi, which we present in hope through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look with favour, Lord, we pray, on these gifts of your church, in which are offered now not gold or frankincense or myrrh, but he who by them is proclaimed, sacrificed and received, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nations. And when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you, firstly, for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Ken, our Bishop, and all those who hold into the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, will they offer it for themselves and for all who adhere to them, for the redemption of their souls and hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day on which your only begotten Son, eternal with you in glory, appeared in a human body, truly sharing our flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious Ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we
celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord. We, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us, who through this participation of the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. To us also, your servants who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Once more praise the Father, and pray to him in the words of Christ himself.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy,
we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The first. one cup of blessing which we bless, and we, though many, throughout the earth, we are.
Let us pray. Go before us with heavenly light, O Lord, always and everywhere, that we may perceive with clear sight and revere with true affection the mystery in which you have willed us to participate. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. They must be worn out after all their singing over Christmas and the New Year, because our choir's been operating on a third capacity this morning, and you couldn't even pick the difference. They came through quite well. So well done to the choir and Vicky there. It's really more of a duet than a choir today, but that's all right. Gift of Epiphany, revelation, that insight, sense we have of God. Have fun celebrating that today, and don't keep it a secret. If you really want to give someone a gift, and I'm not condoning too much trade on Sundays, but Rosie's is running the barbecue at Bunnings today, Bunnings, Toowoomba North. So if you have to get some odds and ends, Toowoomba North, Bunnings, with a sausage attached, might just be the place to go for Rosie's. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.